All right. It is with great pleasure that I would like to introduce you to Téada. They have been touring for over 20 years. They are my favorite Irish band of all time. Woo! with them today are Oisin McDiarmida from County Sligo, Sean Gavin from County Detroit, Paul Finn from County Leash, and Patrick Ducey, who has lived everywhere. New York, Massachusetts, and County Mayo. So I know that we are in for an amazing show tonight, and I'm very excited, and I hope you are too. So give a big round of applause for Téada.
Thanks a million. Thank you, Eileen. You are the very best. The best. We would love you to have you introducing us every night. How are you all doing out there? Fantastic. Well, we're excited to be here. We barely made it. Well, of course, we were always going to make it, but we were spent most of the day in Detroit Airport. And I know. Sean is from Detroit, so we better be very careful what we say about Detroit, right?
That's right. Eileen took my only joke away for the whole night already.
Thank you. Good evening, everybody. Gura mila mahagwev. Do you know what that means? It means thank you very, very much. Gura mila mahagwev. It's great to be back in St. Louis. Hasn't been that long for the boys, but it's been a long, long time for me. So it's great to be here again. My family are still calling it St. Louis, and I'm trying to tell them that's not how they say it. But I'm working on it. The NFL is becoming a big thing on a Sunday night at home, so I'm hoping it'll just, you know, subliminally sink in there somewhere. Come here, it's great to be here. We're going to keep going now with a couple of, a lovely march, actually, that we originally got from the Donegal tradition. And the name of the tune, we usually have to explain it in most venues, but I think I'm okay here. You're used to Irish bands. It's called the Putchin March. There we go. Usually at this point, I have to hand over to my resident translator, and he explains. But yeah, it's along the lines of moonshine, really, that you'd have over here, which Sean has told me is not in his glass.
No. It's just Sprite.
Sprite.
They do a really good Sprite next door.
A couple of different tunes in this set, so give us an old shout there along the way. Give us a bit of encouragement, won't you, when you hear the change? That'd be great. We need all the encouragement we can get today after that journey. But we're here, so let's have a good time. Thanks a million. Thank you.
Thanks a million. Well, you're lively, and we love that. We love that. The livelier you are and the more badly behaved you are, the happier we'll be up here. That last one was the Limerick classes. We played that one for Eileen, who probably is dying to get back to Limerick at some point, I'm sure. Would you like to hear something from Sean on the beautiful linen pipes?
Okay, thanks. So, as Eileen mentioned, I grew up in Detroit. And I learned music mostly from my father and my brother there, Mick and Michael Gavin. But I learned the pipes from a man named Al Purcell, who was a great piper. Yeah. He's got a few fans here. Yeah, he passed away a long time ago, about probably, almost 20 years ago now. But he was a great gentleman and a great piper. And he learned from another great piper, Leo Rosum. And Leo made a set of pipes for Al. And that is the set that I'm going to play for you tonight. And the last time I was here, I remember it was for the Chinal maybe 4 years ago, 3 years ago, something like that. It all blends together, as I'm sure you all know. But I was obsessed with the slow air, the Snowy Breasted Pearl, which is one that Leo Rosum recorded. And I started learning it then, and I almost have it down. So I'll give that one a try for you. Hope you like it.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a million. Well, the next tune is going to be a march. We don't always have a lot of marches in our set, but they're beautiful tunes. And this particular one was written by a famous fiddle player from Ireland. I'm sure most of you will have heard of him, John Sheehan, the fiddler with the Dubliners, that amazing group over so many years. And we didn't mean to record this tune at all because we were down recording in Dingle a while back, and we happened to run into John Sheehan one of the nights in playing in Dingle, and we had a great session with him, and he played this tune and we loved it. So we did the risky thing of going into the studio the following morning and recording it. So.
Yeah, but we were stuck for another track.
That's right.
Let's be honest about it here.
And the good
We're not great at preparing.
That's right. Every other tune we were recording, we only half knew as well, so it's all all fine. You know what I mean? It didn't stand out in particular.
We only had about 7 years to get ready.
So that was John Sheehan's, and it's a gorgeous title. It's called Among Friends. So I think it sums up a lot of these great nights and evenings we've been having on the road here, and it's great to be in St. Louis, back again. The one that follows it was, well, I don't know if the name is quite as good. Maybe it was composed by a mathematician. It's called Hornpipe Number 139. Or a bureaucrat or something like that. Anyway. It's a gorgeous tune. We came across it in the Canon Goodman collection of tunes. And the last tune then, I'm losing track.
You're doing great, actually, Oisín. You're doing really, really well.
The last tune usually is, we call it wherever we're playing. The very first night of the tour, we played in Staten Island. And this tune is genuinely called the Staten Island. But unfortunately, we haven't been quite truthful with some of the audiences, because as we've gone around, we tend to give
it's the St. Louis reel.
I couldn't have put it better myself.
Yeah. This album's actually out very, very soon, you know? So we're very excited about it. And I've been telling all the audiences that one of the tracks on it does feature a friend of Seamus Begley's, a man by the name of John C. Reilly, the A-lister, a Hollywood list, A-lister, and none of the audiences believed me. So do you believe me that he's on it? Yeah, see?
Why not?
It's a real thing, so check it out.
I think they were more impressed by Seamus Begley than John C. Reilly, I think.
I think his career has been struggling, so he was looking for a boost in profile, you know?
As you do.
Yeah.
Gurumila Mahagav.
Have you got the hang of that yet? Yeah. It's nice, isn't it? It's nice. Gurumila Mahagav Galer. We're going to, anyone that's heard us before will probably be well aware that we liked lots of the old tunes. Most of our stuff was the old tunes, but there are some brilliant tunes being composed in the tradition as well, and we're always on the listen out for some of those. And the next set is a set of three brand new tunes in traditional music sense. Anyway, that could mean 20 or 30 years old, but new-ish tunes. I'm going to start the first one myself. It's a tune called Greta's Favourite, written by the great Richard Dwyer, one of the famous Dwyer brothers from West Cork. Second one was written by a man by the name of Michael McCaig from Scotstown, County Monaghan. And the last one is a tune written by Johnny O'Connolly, the brilliant box player from Connemara, son of the legendary Johnny Connolly, the melodeon player, who you might have heard of, and who was very, very good to me as a young kid, actually. Always a great man for sitting down with young children and keeping them playing when all the other people are in the pub playing. He'll be out in the lobby of the hotel trying to bring along the youth. He was amazing to all of us as kids, actually. So you appreciate that when you're older, don't you? You don't think about it at the time, but yeah. So I'm trying to tell Sean to, you know, try pay back. Pay back a little,
you're
Sean.
You're too young.
I'm here playing with you, aren't I, Paul?
It's a pleasure, Sean. It's actually, now that we're talking about it, it's both Sean and Patrick's last night with us tonight, so we'll have to give the two boys a mention as well. It's been a pleasure, lads. We enjoyed it all. A few very insincere laughs along the way as well. Thank you.
Thanks a million, everybody. You've been absolutely fantastic. So good, in fact, that we're going to give you a little break. Intermission. We'll play a couple of reels to finish off with, and the first one's very much associated with County Clare. Do we have any Clare people out there tonight?
Up the banner.
Up the banner. Right. Oh, they're very quiet tonight. It's not like them. Mrs. Crotty, Elizabeth Crotty, the great concertina player from West Clare, played this a lot, as did Michael Russell, the tin whistle player from Doolin. And then the last one's called Ryan's Rant. It's a bit of that these days, but we won't blame poor Ryan for all that rant. It's a grand tune. It was played by the great Dublin fiddle player, Tommy Potts, as well. So we look forward to the second half, and thanks so much. You're an amazing listening audience, but you know how to have a good time as well. So thank you very much, everybody. As regards, there's a lovely CD table set up down there. Unfortunately, there isn't a lot of CDs down there tonight, and I suppose that's a good thing, because we brought out some and they're nearly all gone. We brought out six and there's five left, so we're doing well. But we do have a new album coming out, and a lot of the stuff you've been hearing this evening is a new album, and it's actually, we're picking it up on Tuesday, so it'll be shipping from Tuesday onwards. So if anybody wants to buy a copy here tonight, obviously we can put your details on our list and ship it out to you on Wednesday. Other than that, we're going to have to fight over the last five of the old album. But we have a mailing list as well. We'd love to have anybody join up, and we'll keep you posted with our future shows and all that. So look, we'll finish off with these reels, and I think Sean is buying margaritas for everybody in the audience during the break. So stick with this lad. He's a great fella. Great fella.
Just bright.
Lovely.
we clap, the band will come out.
We're egomaniacs. We had to hear a clap before we came on. That's bright, isn't it?
Yeah, we're not believing it.
Big thanks to David for the margarita. Let's hear it for David.
They should only applaud if they're getting a free one as well.
I was a sign-up sheet in the back there. Just next to the CDs, the five CDs.
That's right, just like the CDs, the margaritas are gone. Well, great to hear about all the upcoming events coming up. Sounds fantastic. Always great. Great music going on in this town, for sure. And I'll be hopefully back myself in May for the FLA, coming up in a couple of months. So we're going to start off the second half with one of our older tunes, actually one of the sets that was on the album that we have tonight, down there. The first one is...
Are they all gone?
Paul, I'm afraid they are. I'll have another one for you for Christmas, don't worry. First tune is called Dinny O'Brien's, and it was a tune that the great Paddy O'Brien, the Tipperary accordion player, wrote for his father, Dinny. Thank you.
Maghreb. Well, I'm supping out of a mug there, which is quite apt for the next one, because the name of the next tune is called Gone for His Tay. Even though it's instant coffee, but that's grand. We got from the playing of Michael Tuberty. And the boys are making me play this one myself. And I've been told to play it slow. And I'm not very good at playing things slow, because I usually want to play things fast. So usually when we're playing slow stuff, I'm not from the West, I don't even say slow. Anyway, this guy, too long hanging around with this guy.
Only when you're being recorded in 4K.
Usually when we play slow stuff, we ask Sean over here, because he's quite an emotional dude, and he's able to get right down to it. So I'll play mine really, really briefly, and we'll get on to the faster stuff. We're going to play a tune written by the great James Kelly, the legendary fiddle player living down in Florida, and he wrote this second one in honor of the legendary Joe Duran, the famous box player. And we'll finish up with a little barn dance written by also legendary Charlie Lennon, and he called this one All About Weaving. But again, we have issues with playing, you know, reasonably moderate tempo, so we're going to play it as a real, really fast.
It's just me, yeah?
Yeah, you're okay. All right
then. F. Thank you.
Great to see the tricolour down there.
The tricolour, my goodness. That's fantastic.
And we beat England at the weekend in the rugby, so you're picking a good weekend to bring it out.
I thought you were going to talk about the hole-in-one today, Paul.
Oh, yeah.
Paul's a great man for the golf.
Anyone see Shane Lowry today on the 17th? In TPC Sawgrass? Hole-in-one.
There you go. A lot to celebrate.
This is my world.
There you go. Well, you've been hearing beautiful, beautiful accompaniment from Patrick Ducey here all the way from County Mayo all evening, haven't you?
In the West.
Well, Patrick's going to play a beautiful, beautiful air for us now. It's called Cheerin' an Oak. Translates as the land of eternal youth. He's going to bring us all to the promised land of eternal youth during this.
Don't fall off the horse.
Thank you.
all the way from County Detroit, Sean Gavin.
Thanks, Paul.
Lovely. Well, Patrick's getting all the great chords out now tonight. The last night, letting it rip. Fantastic. Well, we are getting close towards the end. Oh, we were going to play two more if you said a good long "aw," but... Okay, we'll play three more. Oh, no. Ah, no, you don't want that. We're coming close towards the end, and we're going to play a selection now, which is starts off nice and slow. It's actually... three tunes from a suite called the Emigrant Suite that Charlie Lennon wrote back in the 1980s, a time of huge emigration, as many of you will know. And it starts off with a tune called The Gathering, and then we move into the Piper's Turn, and then it finishes off with a lovely lively reel, and it's got a great name as well, Round the House and Mind the Dresser. That's what they had to do back in the house dances, in the houses back years ago. So we're going to play these three Charlie Lennon tunes for you now, and we're going to start off with the beautiful Linen Pipes from Sean Gavin.
Thank you.
Now that was feshed. Well, thank you very much. Or as they say in the Irish language, well, I hope you buy it. Ma far, or mila mila guava, ma guiv, and it was absolutely brilliant being here for you. And thanks so much for coming out to hear us. And I'm out of breath after the instant coffee.
Paul's going to sing us a song now.
Does anybody want to hear my lovely leash?
It's been a long time coming, but here it is. It'll be on the next album. Well, we'd like to say a huge thank you to everybody here at the Focal Point, and particularly to Eileen Gannon for inviting us here tonight. It's been amazing. And Eric on sound, incredible job.
David on margaritas.
And David on margaritas. But it'd be no fun if you all weren't here cheering us on and making it all fun for us. So give yourselves a huge round of applause. Well, thank you very much, everybody. We're going to finish off with another new selection and four reels, starting with Paddy Ryan's Dream, a Donegal version now, not the Sligo version, so don't be too disappointed. And the last one then is a tune called Tim Fitzpatrick's, named after an accordion player who lived in New York at the turn of the 20th century. So until the next time, and keep an eye out for our new album. It's coming out, as I said, in the middle of next week, and you can find details at Téada.com, and you can check out the rest of our tour dates. We're on the road for about another week, and we hope to be back again in the summertime as well. So thank you very much, everybody. See you soon. On guitar, Patrick Ducey, all the way from County Mayo. Let's hear for Sean Gavin on flute and illipiles. Our very shy singer, but not shy, wonderful accordion player, Paul Finn, all the way from County Leash. Myself, Oisín Mochtí, all the way from Sligo. Thanks very much, everybody. Thank you. very much, everybody.
A million. We weren't expecting that now. Fair play to you. You're mighty. Sure, we might sit in for a session altogether, will we? We'll stay where we are. It's very early. We mentioned the rugby match there on Saturday. As you know, going into battle with the English nowadays, they sing Ireland's Call. But for centuries, they would have played an old war march just to get everybody G'd up. So we might finish with a little war march. A very modern war march composed in 2017 by a lovely composer called Donal McCaig. So we'll finish up with this. And thanks a million again for everyone, and to Eileen and for everyone, and to you for giving us such a great listen. Thank you very much.